If you want a pleasant time when developing in Julia, the first thing to do is to set up a good developing environment. The official website lists different editors and IDEs that you can use along with Julia. There are plugins or extensions for many code editors, and I feel lucky personally because I love VS Code and there is this great extension for Julia in VS Code that is officially supported, so I'm quite happy about it. There's also a Jupyter kernel for Julia, and there is this fantastic package which is called Pluto.gl, and it's a package to write simple yet reactive notebooks in pure Julia. I will make a video in the future about this because I find it quite wonderful actually. So now we will set up our developing environment for Julia by downloading VS Code and installing the VS Code extension for Julia. Visual Studio Code is a code editor developed by Microsoft and it's totally free, which is really nice. Its source code is open source and you can run it on pretty much any platform. And it helps you read and write code using extensions to add any functionality to the editor. And I really like this way of functioning because you only install what you need and not more. I said it. Its code is open source, and it is, but the end product that you download from this web page is distributed under another license because Microsoft adds several things such as telemetry, for example. Now, if you're concerned about Microsoft tracking your data, there is also a free libre version, which is called VS Codium, and this project uses exactly the same source code as Visual Studio Code, but doesn't add, for example, telemetry or any other things that Microsoft could add. So if you're interested, you can download Visual Studio Code from this webpage instead. I'm under Linux, so I'll install from the command line, but I guess you know how to install applications on your computer if you're on macOS or Windows. On Windows, you just click on whatever happens here for you. It's .deb and .rpm because I'm on Linux again. So now I'll install Visual Studio Code on my system. And here it is. I can launch it. So now we'll see how to install the extension for Julia. So here we have a welcome page that we can just close. And to install an extension, you can just click here or press Ctrl+Shift+X. And it will bring you on the kind of market for extension. So here you just have to type Julia, enter. The first one is the good one. You have to click on install, just wait a little bit, and now it's done. So the next thing to do, obviously, is to install Julia. To do so, you can simply go onto the official JuliaLang webpage, julialang.org, and click on download for whatever the version, the last version is available here. And then you can download binaries for your operating system here. So if you're on Windows, for example, you just have to click on this link and it will download it. Then you install it and that's it. So now I'll just install Julia on my computer. Okay, and that's it. Just testing if it works. Yep. Okay, now Julia is installed on my computer. I can open again Visual Studio Code. And now I can launch Julia by pressing Ctrl+Shift+P at the same time and typing Julia start. For example, and now there is this new command that is available to me, Julia start ripple. And if I press enter now, it will open Julia in the terminal of Visual Studio Code. And here it is, I can test it. And okay, it's working. And you have different commands like this. So to get all the commands, you again Ctrl+Shift+P, and you have all the commands appearing here. And you just type Julia, and here you have access to many different commands that you can execute from Visual Studio Code. I personally use two of them, start Julia and stop Julia. If you type Julia stop, you have this command, Julia stop ripple, that appears. And you can stop it from here and start it again. And the commands you used recently appear on top. So it's easy to get again to Julia start ripple, for example. So now if we want to develop Julia script, for example, we can do Control N for new file, save it wherever you are. The best thing is to set up a project in a new workspace, but I'll show you that on another video. Here I'll just show you very quickly how to see a new Julia script, we'll call it. And your Julia scripts have to have the .jl extension. Okay, so here I create it. I just named it julia-scripts.jl, but you can name it obviously as you want. And so now we can write Julia code in our Julia script. And to execute a line of code, we can just press Control and Enter, and it will send the line on which we are onto the REPL and evaluate it and return the result. So for example, if I create a variable a equals 2, I can send it to the REPL by pressing Control and Enter. And now if I want to evaluate the result, a equals 2 here. Now, the extension has several options, and if we want to see the options of the extension, we can click onto Manage and Settings, okay, or just press Control and Comma. And here we can go to Extensions and Julia, okay? So here we have all the options for our extensions. For example, we can set if we want or not telemetry. We can set our path to the executable. Myself, it's on the path, so I don't have to put it here. We can also choose whether the results are printed on the REPL, which is by default, or inline, or both. And the extension has a dedicated website at julia-vscode.org, and there is a nice presentation here, so I make it from here. So first, there is what the extension does is dynamic autocompletion. When you start typing something, it autocompletes for the name of, for example, a function or an object or a structure, whatever, as this, and it will also show you some documentation about, for example, the function. And then you have inline results, which is an option of the extension. So when you execute a code line, the output is either printed on the REPL or inline. So it is an option, and you can also do both inline and in the REPL. I personally like both. Then you have the view of your workspace, which is something from VS Code. You have an outline of the definitions in your file. You have, of course, the integrated REPL, as I showed you earlier, and you have also plot pane. When you make a plot from Julia, it will appear here. If you make several plots, you can go back to previous plots also, which is really nice. So this is the main presentation. You have also an integrated debugger, and I'll make a whole video about that because it can be complicated for someone that doesn't know how to debug. And there is also an option to make remote development, meaning that you can have Visual Studio Code installed on another machine and access it from the instance on this Visual Studio Code from your computer, from your own Visual Studio Code instance. And the last thing I wanted to show you is that you can change the visual appearance of Visual Studio Code. And coming from the Atom editor myself, I find Atom really beautiful. And I wanted to have the same experience in Visual Studio Code. And I'll show you that actually it's quite simple to change the appearance to match the one from Atom. So first, I add some code just to show you how the appearance changed, because here just with 2 or 3 lines, it's difficult to show. So here it's a function with one argument, with a default, for example, and some coordinate a plus 2, I don't know. And here we will call our function, okay? And now, if we want to change the appearance, we just have to install yet another extension. Okay, so you have to click on the extension pane, and here just type Atom, and you'll see there are many themes to match Atom, but the one we will install is this one, the one from Mahmoud Ali, which is installed 1.7 million times, so it's a pretty famous one. You just have to click on it and it will install, and here it will let you choose if you want the dark plus or the default one, and I prefer the Atom one dark, so I click it here, and that's it. Now it's set up. We have Atom like colors that I really prefer myself, but you can find many other themes here. If you type theme, for example, you will have many other themes, and you can click on it and see, well, this is for icons, but I'm sure there are, Monokai theme, for example. You can change the theme, and this one, Monokai, is particularly beautiful also. And well, I think that's it. We saw how to install VS Code, how to install the Julia extension and change the appearance. The next thing to do is to actually write Julia code. And in the next video, we will see how to set up Julia with Pluto.jl to write reactive notebooks. And this is quite different yet complementary approach of writing Julia code. Using notebooks, it's, for me at least, it's more telling a story about, for example, data with plots, etc. And this video is part of a playlist. So if you're interested in learning Julia, you can follow all the videos I make in order from the playlist. Thank you for watching, and if you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments. I'll see you next time.